गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, ए वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन आवर न्यू सेशन ऑफ डिजिटल गुरुकुल। नमस्कार दोस्तों, डिजिटल गुरुकुल में मैं श्रीकांत आप लोग सबका एक बार फिर से स्वागत करता हूं। तो दोस्तों, आज मैं आप लोग के सामने लेकर आया हूं एक बहुत ही अच्छा अवार्ड विनिंग, ठीक है, ऐसे जो आपके आने वाले एग्जाम्स के लिए बहुत ही हेल्पफुल साबित होगा। चाहे आप कोई भी एग्जाम्स की तैयारी कर रहे हो जिसमें ऐसे राइटिंग होते हैं, आजकल के बहुत सारे एग्जाम्स में ऐसे की राइटिंग की जरूरत पड़ती है, और आप लोग इसे ध्यान से देखिए कि किस तरह से आपको ऐसे राइटिंग करना है। ये बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है आपके आने वाले एग्जाम्स के लिए। तो चलिए दोस्तों, शुरू करते हैं। आज के ऐसे का टॉपिक है द फ्यूचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी, ठीक है। तो स्टार्ट करते हैं कि ऐसे क्या होना चाहिए, किस तरह से उसका होना चाहिए, आपको बताने की शुरू करते हैं। तो चलिए दोस्तों, शुरू करते हैं द फ्यूचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी। Democracy not only a way of government, but it also a way of life. The modern age is a democratic age. Democracy has been defined differently by various philosophers of the past and modern times. The Greek philosopher like Plato and Aristotle defined democracy as a mebocracy, or the rule of crowds, because demo is derived from the Greek word demos, which means crowd, and kreshi from the Greek word kratos or kratia, which means power. The Greek philosophers like Plato and Aristotle did not admire democracy. They considered that it was a bad type of government because it creates instability and was a weak type of government. Of course, nowadays democracy is not considered to be a bad type of government, rather it is regarded as the best possible government. Democracy has been defined differently by several writers. According to Professor Seely, it is a government in which everyone has a share. According to the Brescia, democracy is that form of government in which ruling power of a state is largely vested in the members of community as a whole. The best definition, however, was given by Abraham Lincoln. According to him, it is a government of the people, by the people, and for the people. Thus, in a democracy, the people are supreme and sovereign. The people elected the government in the time of election according to their free will. Democracy can further be classified into two types, direct and indirect democracy. In direct democracy, the people themselves act as a supreme law-making body. They elect the rulers and dismiss them. They make the law and change them. But in indirect democracy, the people elect the representative who functions as a parliament. They elect representative of the people, make the law on behalf of the people. They also choose the party which is to run the administration of the country. Direct democracy was possible only in the past in the Greek city-states when the population was very small. Nowadays, generally, there is a representative steps of the democracy or indirect democracy in a few cantons of Switzerland. Still, some form of direct democracy can be found. Now, democracy has not met with success everywhere in the world. It has been a success in some countries of the world like Switzerland, UK, USA, France, Canada, etc. In Switzerland, democracy is such a great success that Switzerland and democracy are considered to be synonymous. In UK also, democracy has been a big success. It was not wrong to call UK the mother of parliamentary democracy in the world. But on the other hand, we find that democracy has not been very successful in many other countries. For example, in countries of Asia, Africa, and Latin America, it has failed miserably. In Asia, there are very few countries where the experiment of democracy has met with some success. In reality, there are certain conditions which are very essential for the success of democracy. Some of these conditions are educated masses, enlightened public opinion, economic equality, well-organized political parties, freedom of press, priorities leader means patriotic leaders. While their air conditions are available in the country of the Europe and USA, they are lacking in the countries of Asia, Africa, and Latin America. Thus, democracy has failed in the countries where their preconditions are not present. In India, which is the largest democratic in the world, the great experiment is going on. If democracy is a success in our country, then its future is quite bright in Asia. On the other hand, if it fails, then it will be totally eclipsed in Asia. Of course, democracy has been quite successful in our country during the last 60 years. That credit of the strong foundations of democracy goes to our leaders like Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Lal Bahadur Shastri, Indira Gandhi, etc. However, communalism, casteism, regionalism and provincialism are posting a great threat of democracy in India. Besides, India masses, despite more than 74% of literacy rate, have failed to correctly utilize their wallet power, money and muscle power. Casteism of rust types, etc. rule the roost. Unless where the leaders rise above this petty considerations, the future of true democracy in India seems black. तो दोस्तों ये थे आज के जो हैं ऐसे अबाउट डेमोक्रेसी मीन्स टॉपिक था द फ्यूचर ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. तो दोस्तों मैं ऐसे ऐसे आप लोग के लिए लाता रहूँगा. थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग माई वीडियो. जय हिंद जय भारत दोस्तों.